on that just yet. We're going to have to wait and see.
The region's made up of miles of shallow water, famous for shrimp and oysters. Down here, the land is interspersed with wild marshes, beaches, and inlets. These unique wetlands have been coveted as a home to rare birds and animals. And look at them now. Fishermen told us they'd seen oil 8 inches thick. Some of the black goo has separated and floats in slimy clods. Millions of gallons of the dark poison saturate the water. This, a glimpse of what the fish eat and breathe now.
We're 43 miles here from the place where the oil has been spewing out of the pipe. And as you can see, it's still really thick. This whole area absolutely stinks. It smells like petrol. And the point of this boom is to stop the oil from hitting the coastline. But all it takes is one little wave and it slurps right over. You can see the stained grass over there. And of course, this is devastating for the wildlife.
Moira Wood has spent years working to protect these marshes. But with the oil coming in waves now, she says there's no point in even trying to clean this grass. Her worst fear is for the rare species decades from now.
Well, we know from our experience with the Exxon Valdez that some species have recovered completely, that some species are still recovering, and that some species have not recovered at all. And that's 20 years later.
The Gulf is one of the only places you'll ever see this rare sea turtle. And the sea turtles here have been drinking the oil. Brown pelicans can barely move in their new world of stinking sludge. It's hard for them to fish and breed now. And these birds just got off the endangered list. Nearby, Billy Nungesser, who runs the parish with the longest coastline in Louisiana, was on the warpath. He was hoarse from weeks of shouting about what he sees as the slow response all around to a crisis he regards as worse than Hurricane Katrina 5 years ago. Billy wants BP to build a giant sand wall along the coastline. He was angry at the delay.
The most incredible thing today is here we're here 2 weeks later, and we're seeing another part of South Louisiana devastated with oil, Southeast Pass. Breaks my heart.
BP has now committed millions of dollars to build the sand wall, but for Billy, it's too little, too late.
We're in the fight of our life. This is worse than 10 Katrinas.
Why do you say that?
Because it could go on for many years. Imagine having a Katrina every week for 10 years. It all continues to come ashore as we stand here. It's destroying another piece of coastal Louisiana.
Well, BP says they're doing everything they can to clean up the mess.
That's an absolute lie. Absolute lie. Everything they can, they've been forced to pay for the berm. I wouldn't have had to go to Arkansas and find 100 skimmers. That's BP's job. I don't mind doing it, but damn it, step up to the plate and pay for it.
On May 27th came news that shook America. Officials concluded that 10 to 20 times more oil had been gushing out a day than first stated. And all the efforts to stop the never-ending eruption so far had failed. With the growing cacophony of anger, the penny finally dropped at the White House. This could be the biggest crisis of the Obama presidency. President Obama was playing catch-up. He needed to deflect growing criticisms of his role, so he let rip against BP. Teams of experts, he said, would help him hunt down the guilty.
We talked to these folks because they potentially had the best answers, so I know who's asked to kick.
And make no mistake, all this is costing BP dear. They've hired thousands of local workers and boats and paid for millions of feet of boom. BP spent $1.75 billion on the cleanup and compensation, and last week committed $20 billion more to a separate fund. I wanted to find out if all this money was working.
Well, all this shows you just how painstaking and difficult it is to clean up oil. I'm standing here at the site of the biggest oil spill in America's history, and they're cleaning it up with shovels and their hands and putting the oil into bin bags.
The scale of all this and BP's early decision to play it down has left them on the defensive. BP refused to talk to Panorama. I tried to talk to the BP workers here to find out how long all this would take them.
How many bags a day are you?
No comment.
Why no comment? Can you tell us a little bit about what you're doing here? Have you been given instructions not to speak to the press?
Yep.
You have? By who? By the Pelicans.
If openness can save face, it seems no one's told BP. Their handling of this has become a public relations fiasco. BP's accused of covering up the real size of the spill early on. Its promises to stop the leak have failed. The oil may keep gushing till August or even December, but BP's promises keep coming.
We are here for the long haul. We are going to clean every drop of oil off the shore. We will remediate any environmental damage, and we will put the Gulf Coast right and back to normality as fast as we can.
Down here, few trust what BP's chief executive, Tony Hayward, says anymore. Venice, Louisiana would normally be thriving at this time of year, but shrimping's been banned. The shrimp may not be fit for consumption.
So usually this would just be pouring, shrimp pouring out.
A.C. Cooper would normally be raking in $50,000 a month at this time of year, but all he's got so far is a $5,000 compensation payment from BP.
How long have you been in the shrimping business?
All my life. 50 years. I'm 50 years old. I've probably been doing it since I was 15.
And your family?
My father still does it. He's 74. My two sons and my son-in-law. So we have a whole family that does it. What are they going to do? That's more what my concern is. What are they going to do? I'm 50 years old. You know, I might have 20 more years left. They got the rest of their lives. That's where the problem is going to lie. Our heritage is going to be stopped right here. And you're going to, and it's a lot more than just all clean up. A lot more than just the industry. It's a heritage. It's a way of life. We're angry, we're mad, we're frustrated.
One evening, we went to a gathering of shrimpers and fishermen nearby. People here accused BP of penny pinching on compensation.
We want BP to pay. Pay. As one of my clients said, and I'll be quiet, he said, you know what? I didn't go to the UK and dump my oysters at the headquarters of BP, but they sure as hell came to my oyster beds and dumped their oil. Pay up.
BP's management has refused to accept all the blame. After all, the rig was owned by Transocean, and designs had been signed off by the federal government. President Obama himself was a backer of deep water drilling in the Gulf. Tony Hayward's protest didn't win him any public sympathy here, though.
There's no one who wants this thing over more than I do. You know, I'd like my life back.
Texas is the throbbing heart of America's oil industry. I went to Houston to try to find out why this disaster happened. America is the land of the lawyer, and BP's future may depend on what they did wrong. I was on my way to visit one very successful lawyer, Tony Busby. And guess how he rose to the top? By suing BP. BP has a terrible safety record here. As Texan lawyers say, BP's easy pickings. The company was fined over $100 million after safety errors in 2005 led to 15 deaths at its Texas City refinery. Tony Busby now represents 15 Deepwater Horizon rig workers, including Micah and Steve.
BP, in my view, has a long history, and it's almost a callousness, an indifference to worker safety. A willingness to make decisions that put people's lives at risk, all because they want to save themselves money.
Same town, different lawyer. Jeff Seeley is acting for 7 survivors. His clients are reluctant to talk openly about what went on the rig. They're filing negligence cases against BP and the other companies involved.
Explain some of the issues that y'all were having, let's say, in the 90 days before this happened.
High numbers of gas, you know.
I was allowed to listen in on some of the evidence. The picture it paints puts BP in the dock.
I believe based upon what I've seen and heard, is that's why this job was being rushed throughout this process.
Was there a lot of pressure on the rig?